Hi there, Scott here for the Curling Store, and today we're going to talk about curling brooms. Usually the first thing that people want to do when they get into the sport of curling is they want to get a curling broom. They're nice, they're shiny, there's different colors, there's different weights. While the curling shoe is actually a little bit more important because it's going to allow you to slide and the game is sliding, the curling broom is a close second in terms of the equipment that you need. Generally speaking, the lighter the broom, the easier it is to push. So we have the range from the heaviest kind of fiberglass handle, more of a white style handle, not real sexy with a stationary head, lower cost, to the mid-range brooms like these two, the composites. So they're middle of the road in terms of price and weight, to our 100% carbon fiber, which is, you know, just a pure pleasure to sweep with, easier on the shoulders if you're playing a lot of games in a short period of time. Or towards the end of a game, allows you to have more in the tank at the end of the game, so you can pull that rock a little further. There's subtle differences between each broom. Some are tapered, some are the same thickness the whole way, some are thin, some are thick. We have the brush heads. Each company has their own kind of patented brush head system, and all these brooms will accommodate any of the WCF approved compliant pads. We generally wouldn't recommend those for club or recreational curling, as they wear out quicker, they're expensive, and they're less effective. For your club players, something like an EQ or a Pro or the Goldline Airway pad, it's a waterproof coated material. It's super effective for sweeping and is not gonna wear out as quick, so you're not changing your brush heads all the time. Check out more of our videos at thecurlingstore.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel.